The spike is collectively referred to as the downside, but they're not a bunch of pessimists. The spike is critical to the running of Absalom Station, however, it is vastly underappreciated. Very large machinery and tech are wedged into very small spaces to keep not only the defenses going for Absalom Station, but also the critical life support systems. And the engineers in charge of fixing and maintaining these systems, these very critical systems, only half understand what they're doing. Today we're going to talk about the spike, some neighborhoods, and places of interest you might want to take your players in your Starfinder game. Let's get into it. Hello everyone, welcome to the table. My name's Nathaniel. This is a channel where we discuss lore around some of your favorite role-playing games and mine, such as Starfinder and World of Darkness. If that's something you're interested in, I would love to have you join me at the table. And you can also join the Discord and the Patreon if you are interested. Links are in the descriptions below. Now, the spike isn't a very pretty place to live, and you will notice that the citizens are some of the poorest in the station. The lower down you get, the less natural light you get from the sun and the wealth and the glass dome, and the poorer it becomes. The wealthy zones of Absalom were actually built on top of half-explored or unfinished corridors, as well as the neighborhoods that are beneath them, and criminals and monsters alike can be found roaming around the station in these unfinished halls or these ghost levels, if you will. And although the criminal groups do tend to use these corridors and try to explore them, there is no apparent reason as to why monsters can be found on the station, especially when some of these have no business being there. A very common promise for those who are trying to gain political power is trying to clean up the lower levels. They're trying to clean up the downside. They will root out the monsters and promise to clean things up and make it better for everyone. However, as with any campaign promise, there are many scientists and even magicians, those scholared in the ways of magic, who will tell you or tell the person who wins that they can't change or root out these life forms because they have their own magical ecosystems and monster habitats and environmentalists in space. They argue that these monsters or these ecosystems will hold the key as to why Absalom is the way that it is, how it was built, and why it was built. Now, in the downside, there are many places of interest and neighborhoods that you can take your players on adventures through. People do still live in these areas, and there are plenty of businesses that have sprung up to service not only the population that lives there, but also to avoid the watchful eye of maybe the stewards or some of the Absalom private police. The downside is also made up of hundreds of levels. And the first neighborhood that you would get to when you are going down into the depths of the station would be an area called Downlow. And this is probably the safest neighborhood in the seedier part of Absalom Station. In levels 9 to 19, you're going to find the entire area of Downlow. Now, there's affordable housing here. There is affordable retail spaces here as well. It's also quite a cosmopolitan area as well. So you will see quite a diverse group of people living here. You will see a lot of Sheeran-owned bars. You will also see Kasathans and some Reforians who will try to recruit you into some of the sensation houses. Law enforcement will be pretty difficult to find in this area as well. However, this problem has mostly been picked up and solved by low-key gangs who just want to keep the peace. Marshals, self-appointed marshals, if you will. There are still quite a lot of raids, and you will have the Pact police come in and do their usual search and shakedown of things. But other than seeing those large-scale raids, you won't really see a lot of them in this area. Now, in a station like Absalom, or any space station for that matter, you can't have any waste. Everything has to be recycled, everything has to be reusable. You can't waste anything because it's very difficult to get stuff into space. Botscrap is effectively, as it sounds, it is a private robotics junkyard. It is owned and run by the Salvage Union, which is comprised of mostly Yosoki. Any spare parts or even discarded military equipment that is deactivated can be found in Botscrap. Now, Botscrap does get to be a little bit more dangerous. It's a little bit lower down in the station, but these piles of junk, these piles of robotics, they do have a bit of a goblin problem. Goblins have built their warrens and built their nests into the piles of garbage, and they run their own periodic raids or cause mischief and trouble in the area of Botscrap. Now, in levels 63 to 69, this is an area known as Sparks. It is the engineering level of Absalom Station. Here you will find massive docks for building or repairing starships. You will also find smaller tech shops, which are really only big enough for one or two people. They're pretty specialized. Most of the people you will see here are poor to middle class at best. They are mid-skilled laborers. There's not a ton here. A lot of wealth passes through these corridors, but it usually goes up. If you wander off the well-beaten path when it comes to Sparks, you can get yourself into a bit of trouble. Many of the shops who set up outside of the protected areas or the well-known corridors, this is where the private security as well as the public security, some homemade militias or homemade factions have formed groups to try to keep everything safe, at least as much as they can. The areas outside of this protection will have problems with Vexkits, Gremlins, Mephits, as well as lightning elementals. Sometimes these elementals are summoned, sometimes they happen to spawn with random electrical discharges, and some of the electrical wiring, the conduits inside the station, being that it's this far down, they'll just appear because of this. There's also street gangs, so you gotta watch out for the shakedowns on top of the elementals. In levels 88 and 89, going even further down into the station, you will find the neighborhood of Conduit. However, everybody calls it Pipetown. Natives of this district are extremely proud, but also very poor. Locals will quite often have a set of crooked pipes tattooed on their body somewhere. Now, with all the pipes and the conduits that Absalom contains, when you start getting this low into the station, you run into a bit of a problem. The conduit and the piping at this level, it forms a labyrinth, a three-dimensional maze, not only left and right, but also up and down. Engineers who have schematics that are drawn of the area still get lost. Locals are often hired as guides to navigate this incredible maze. Pipetown also has specialized hunters. They will specifically go out and try to find leakages, water leakages, or breakages in the conduit pipes. Anything that is leaking or not supposed to be leaking, they will go out and try to fix or hunt down and send for the right crews to deal with the problem. These groups also have to be vigilant for monsters that are in the area. Garmals like to feed on the power. You have problems with water tigers. And then there's the Colmars, and they just like to eat the sewage and the local inhabitants. So they are a problem. With the neighborhoods of the Spike covered, there's still just a few places of interest that I would like to share with you now. Diamond's Defense and Surplus is one of them, but I did cover it in my original Absalom video, which I will link up here. The Rig House is run by the Low Rigger Gang. It's a little run down, but it's so large, nobody knows how many rooms it actually has, and the gang kind of likes it like this. It is often used for many things, sometimes at the same time. It is used as a nightclub, it is used as a performing venue, it hosts meetings for rich and famous people, and sometimes it doubles as a government building for the government of the Spike. It's also said that if you've earned the trust of the Low Rigger Gang, they will allow you onto an exclusive list. And what gaining access to this list does for you, you will gain access to private training areas. You will gain access to better deals, more secret information, the premium jobs, if you will. They will also, of course, hide you from the law, and if you really need to, it's rumored that they have access to smuggler tunnels that are hidden throughout the Absalom space station. Going even deeper than we have thus far, you will find the Starstone reactor. This is the power source for the entirety of Absalom Station. This is also what serves as the beacon, the hyperspace or the drift beacon that anyone can find within a couple of days, no matter where you are in the galaxy. Absalom also has an elite guard, and they are hired to protect the Starstone reactor room. You cannot get close to it. Only engineers who have the station's highest security clearance are actually allowed to touch any of the controls that transfer power from the Starstone to the station. The Absalom government also uses this ruse or this guise of not letting anyone in unless they have the security clearance, it hides the fact that nobody could get into the Starstone reactor room if they wanted. The Starstone itself is actually in a chamber that floats in a mostly empty room. This chamber is connected by conduit that go into Absalom Station, but other than that, you cannot access the Starstone directly. There is some walkways and some paths around it that have the machinery that the engineers would use, but there's no way to physically access the stone. And these corridors that go into this mostly empty room with those, with that machinery, you can't get through the doors. The codes that were used to lock them were apparently lost during the gap. And if you don't use the right code, a very powerful, very deadly magical defense system activates and obliterates anyone who tries, and it brownouts the station. Knowing how deadly the defense system is, this hasn't stopped people from trying to touch the Starstone. The legends of Ayamade and ascending to godhood for simply touching the Starstone still live on in Starfinder today. Some of the engineers who have been cleared to work in this area have found that inside the room there is flickers of ghostly images, people wearing traditional clothing of Absalom Station. It's rumored or believed by some of the magical scholars and some of the top engineers that although there is an Absalom mandated guard, there is also a Starstone guard of some type. No one is entirely sure about this though. The Spike is a fantastic place for running adventures, even just a sandbox adventure for your players. There's lots to do here. Absalom is a wonderfully created and a wonderfully crafted zone that you could just run a whole campaign here and never leave Absalom. You would really miss out on some of the other mechanics of Starfinder and some of the other uses for it, but it's totally doable. What were some of your favorite places in the Spike? Tell me about them in the comments below. I would also like to thank those who allow me to continue to explore the ghostly corridors of Starfinder, my patrons. Autumn Alchemist, Orbs McMillans, RRSPQ, Ducky, Vox, Caneroot, Warpony, Get of Mathrox, BA Bravo, Arutvin, The First Layer, Bones Malone, Westheimer, and Ain't No Waifu. Thank you for your continued support for me and for the channel. If you have been a fan of my channel and the work that I'm doing here, then please consider supporting me on Patreon. Link is in the description below. If this is your first time here and you haven't seen any of my videos before, I will encourage you to check out the playlist of Absalom Station on your screen now. My name's Nathaniel. This has been The Maple Table. Thank you so much for your subscription, and thanks for stopping by, everyone.